Good afternoon, my dear students. Today, I am teaching class 10, chapter number 6, Molecular Basis of Inheritance. In the last lecture, we have seen about transcription in eukaryotes. We have seen splicing process, capping and tailing was included in that. I hope you have read that topic. Now, we'll be starting with, before moving to the translation process, let me give you an idea of genetic code, gene expression. Once you will not understand this topic, then translation will not be fruitful. So, what do we mean by genetic code? So, genetic code is the relationship between the nucleotides in the mRNA, between the sequence of nucleotides in the mRNA and the sequence of amino acids and the sequence of amino acids in the polypeptide chain. Okay, so genetic code is the relationship between these two entities, the nucleotides in mRNA and amino acids in the polypeptide. So, in year 1954, one scientist named George Gemmell, he proposed that in order to produce a single amino acid, three triplet codes are used, or three nucleotides are used to code for one amino acid, and he called these three codes as the triplet code. Okay, suppose one base is required for producing one amino acid, that means four base pairs will be there to require to or to produce one amino acid. So if one base pair is there, then what will be there? Four amino acids will be made. And if suppose two base pair sequence we are taking, so we will be getting 16. How? 4 multiplied by 4. So, but here it is triplet codon, that means 3 base pair will be 4 into 4 into 4. That accounts for 64 codons. That means in order to generate the essential 20 amino acids, what we require? We require 64 codons. But this is extra. Okay, it is 3 more extra. So what are these extra? These will be known as the terminating codons. We will be learning once we will be seeing the genetic code table. Okay. So students, how do we get to know there is a triplet codon? So there were in the year 1960s, three discoveries or three research was being made by three scientists. First scientist was Har Gobind Khurana. He designed a chemical method for the synthesis of RNA molecule. That means he had discovered about homopolymer and copolymer. Next scientist was Marshall Nirenberg. What this scientist has done? He has discovered or deciphered the genetic code system in a cell-free system, which helped in deciphering the genetic code. The third scientist was Severo Ochoa. What he said? He said there is enzymatic synthesis of the RNA molecule with the help of enzyme known as polynucleotide phosphorylase. With the help of this enzyme, RNA synthesis takes place. Now we will be, with all these three discoveries, we have generated a table of the genetic code, which constituted of three codons. What was that? If we are drawing that table, this can be, here we will be writing the second base, here we will be writing the first base, and here we'll be writing the third base. Okay, so U C A G, uracil, cytosine, adenine and guanine. Same way the second base pair will be also having U C A G in the same manner. U C A G. Okay, got it? But in the third base we will be taking for each particular, so that there is a combination of triplet codon U C A G. U C A G, it will be for the second. That means if I have to code for this amino acid, it will be first base is U, second base is U and third base is U. And if we are drawing the second base for this, first base is U, second base code will be this and third will be C. Third base pair will be taking from here. Same way again it will be U, U, A. So like this, total 64 codons will be generated and whole this table will be there. In the next lecture, we will be learning about the general features of the genetic code, general features of the triplet codon and what are the different names of these amino acids, and we will be learning about the terminating codons also. Students, please go through this topic, genetic code. It is very important because what happens? In the exam, names of the scientists have been asked, their contribution and drawing of this table has also been asked several times. So please students, stay at home, study this topic from your NCERT, and thanks.